an effort to stabilize Afghanistan, the U.S. Marines created female engagement teams. This program involves interaction with Afghan women. A professor from OU School of Visual Communication went along to document their stories. Rebecca Sell joins us now in our studio, and we're going to talk about it. Thanks for being here tonight.
Thanks for having me.
So you went to Afghanistan back in 2010, and you were there to report on female engagement teams. Can you talk a little bit about what these teams are?
Sure. Female engagement teams are small groups and teams of female Marines, specifically. The first group in 2010 were the first full-time female engagement teams to go over. Before that, they were considered part-time. And so what they do is they interact with the women in Afghanistan and the children in Afghanistan, as well as the men in Afghanistan, as male Marines can't have contact with women over there. It's considered inappropriate.
So we're actually looking at one of your, we were looking at one of your pictures a second ago. Maybe we'll pop that back up here for everyone. But talk a little bit maybe about this first image and what it's showing.
So where I was stationed was in Musa Qala, which is in the Helmand province of Afghanistan. And some people think that that's quite desert-like, but it's surrounded by basically a river called a wadi. And so this is that area where people could take their farmland.
Absolutely. And then we have another one, I think, if we can move ahead to that one. And this one shows, it looks like children next to some heavily armed militia people.
Yeah, this is Rosemary Epperdy, Lance Corporal Rosemary Epperdy, and the children are staring at her because when the women walk through town, they're not used to seeing women uncovered, and so it's basically like a big pink elephant walking down the middle of the street. So they all gather and watch and follow her.
All right, and then we have one more I think we're going to show here. So what's going on in this one?
So this is the women waiting to go on patrol with the men. The women can't go outside of the military area by themselves. They have to go along with men. They're considered not allowed to be on the front line. So they're more of a group that goes out to interact with the women, but the men have to accompany them to keep them safe.
They're really interesting pictures. So now, getting back to these engagement teams, how do you think they help the U.S. war effort?
I think it's all part of a counterinsurgency effort. So it's actually a very small piece of a very large puzzle. Most of it's probably going to make a change over the long term, over the course of years and years. Even the women who were there communicated that in their short span of 7 months in the area, they can only do so much change to affect a culture and to get to know the women who have been kept alone in compounds for most of their lives.
Now, focusing on you being over there, they always talk about this embedding process, especially when you go to an area kind of like a war zone. How was it for you as a photojournalist?
I think it was a fascinating experience. I felt lucky enough to be able to talk to former students and alumni that have come through the School of Visual Communications, including Victor Blue and Chris Hondros, who was recently killed in Libya. So that was a good warm-up to being over there. But as far as the experience goes, I felt really lucky to get to know the men and the women working over there, as well as the locals.
Well, it's really interesting stuff. Becky Sell, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.